Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back for our fifth and final concert of the summer. Tonight, Forever Fab, who have been together for 5 years now, will be performing Beatles covers. You can send requests. Shout them out. This group was sponsored fully by the Georgetown Cultural Council, which was a grant that was written way back in the fall, January. So we're delighted. We also have Salem 5 with us. Salem 5 Charitable Foundation was a big contributor to our expenses. And we also have BioClean Carpet, Green Carpet Cleaning Services. Some information over there, and he is giving us a free carpet cleaning service for one lucky person. At our intermission, we'll do a 50-50, and then the other prize will be a free carpet cleaning for that person. What else? So I mentioned the 50-50. I just want to thank everyone for coming out and for supporting us. Please check our sponsors and town that we've had. We had some awesome people who stepped up to help us out. The police have been wonderful. Park and Rec. And just the neighbors coming together and being cooperative with us for parking. I think I'm going lower. So let's give it up for Forever Fab.
I'm going to sing with my navel on that one. Thank you. So as As the lady said, we are Forever Fab. We're doing music of the Beatles for your listening enjoyment. Show of hands, how many Beatles fans do we get out there tonight? Oh, good. That's good. That's a good start. Hopefully we'll have a few more by the end. So a couple housekeeping items. First of all, how's the volume? Okay. Anyone ears bleeding? Okay. Looks like everyone's pretty good with it.
We'll give them a little technical advice. The further away you are from the speakers, believe it or not, the louder it gets. Just to let you know, because everybody's always away. Speakers are meant to go out. So you're in a very high SPL area. So next time you come to see a band, come a little closer, even more comfortable.
Yeah, that's Bob Nye, the science guy back there, who just gave you that little technology lesson. But the second thing we wanted to mention is that at our concerts, we like to play the songs that you want to hear. And so to that end, what we would ask is that in between songs, if you could just yell out your favorite Beatles song. Try not to yell them at the same time, but just use your most loudest voice, because we're deaf up here, and just shout them out, and we'll try to cover them. Now, the Beatles have somewhere around 270-some-odd songs in their total catalog. We don't do all 270-some-odd, but we do quite a few, and hopefully we're going to do the ones that you want to hear. So, give that some thought, and here's another couple from the Ed Sullivan Show.
Let's do, about two.
Second up, and she knows she's second up, and she knows he was to say hey. She said she loves you,
Thank you very much. Thank you, thank you. So any requests?
Penny Lane.
Penny Lane. Hey Jude.
Birthday.
Eleanor Rigby. Okay, we'll go with those four for now.
In Penny Lane, there was a barber showing photographs. Oh, the three ladies had the pleasure to know. And the people that come and go stop and say hello. On the corner of the bank, a little broken glass. The little children love him behind his back.
Must be going crazy right now.
I was hoping it was a bat. But...
So, Penny Lane was Paul McCartney's attempt, I guess, at reminiscing about his childhood back in Liverpool. John Lennon had his own version of reminiscing, which was Strawberry Fields. It was actually the flip side to that single, which came out somewhere around 68, I think, just before Sgt. Pepper. So we're gonna send this one out to you too.
Oh,
you. Thank you so much.
Let's go.
So Denise, we had, yeah. Okay. So birthday, folks, we have a very auspicious occasion today. Our lead player, Phil Donovan, is 60 years old today. Phil turned 60 on this very day.
Where'd you make those numbers up? I can't even count that high, man.
We thought it was a lab report. We didn't realize you had a birth certificate.
Of course, you couldn't tell by looking at him. No, absolutely not. Oh. Phil is a very young 60.
Very right.
So we're going to send this one out to Phil and anyone else who might have a birthday today. Twist and Shout. Technically, not really a Beatles song, but you know what? The Beatles made a lot of money off of that one, I think, on their first album. And now you guys can dance to it if you'd like.
Now.
thank you so much. We got a request to Eleanor Rigby. You know, we left our string quartet at home. I'm not sure how we're going to do this without our string quartet. Oh, wait a minute. We've got Fran here.
But wait, there's more.
But wait, there's more. And we've got Phil over here on Ebo, too. Being attacked by hornets back there, apparently. But we signed a waiver, so I guess well, he'll just have to live with it.
The song ahead. I hope he stings him right.
This is Bob on vocals. So we got a request, I know, for Revolution. Revolution is probably the closest thing that the Beatles did to a heavy metal song. They got a really crazy, dirty sound out of their guitars on this, which is really a little bit difficult to duplicate live. And you know, while I'm on that subject, I should mention to you folks that, you know, a lot of bands, especially Beatles tribute bands, will have to resort to pre-recorded music in their performance to try to get that original sound. You will not hear any pre-recorded music up here. Everything you hear on this stage is live by these four musicians. So we don't cheat. It's all, everything you hear is the real thing.
It's all right with this.
Step up on it.
USSR, which was the Beatles' answer, I think, to the Beach Boys, and a little bit of a parody there on the Soviet Union version of the Beach Boys.
I sent this out to my buddy John.
Johnny!
You made it, huh?
Not far.
You know how to be divine.
So, we got a request for a song, which Paul McCartney does at every single concert, because this song is arguably the Beatles' most successful, I think, recording, and it was called Hey Jude. Although originally, the song was called Hey Jules, and it was written for John Lennon's son, Julian, back when John Lennon left his family home. Julian was somewhat despondent over this, of course, and so Paul wrote this kind of as a means of maybe comforting him to some extent. It's a great tune. Sing along, because we know that you know the words.
Hey Jude, don't make it bad. Take a sad song.
Thank you so much. We got a request for a Norwegian Wood, which is a song John Lennon penned. And it's the first U.S. song, I believe, pop song, to feature a sitar in it, which was an instrument that George Harrison noticed when he was with the Maharishi in India. So he brought it back and put it on the recording. And we're going to feature Fran over here on fake sitar. Western song that Paul McCartney penned. I want to let Phil tell you the sad, sad story about Rocky.
I got a story about you for Rocky. Poor Rocky. Just be glad you're not here. Somewhere in the Black Mountains, there's a big coat that lived a young boy named Rocky Raccoon. One day, one rattle will die. Get that boy. So one day he walked into town to book himself a room in the book of saloon. Had broken his dream.
scratch. And I'm a better, doctor, soon as I am able. Now Lucky Raccoon checked into his room. I only took 5 years Bible. Well, did you check out?
Neck, we're going to do a song which is the Beatles' very first hit back in 63. The very first song that they charted with. Okay. And it's called Love Me Do. Sponsors.
Okay, it's intermission time. We're going to do that 50-50 raffle, and as part of that raffle prize, there'll be a free carpet cleaning.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you. You guys are great. We really do appreciate it. We got a request earlier on for a song called Paperback Writer. Now here's a song which the Beatles used some studio tricks to get a really that really distinctive harmony sound. They did 6 overdub vocals to get that sound. We've only got 4 guys up here, but we're gonna do it with 4, and we're gonna do it live. It's a somewhat obscure, I think, older Beatles song, and it was requested by somebody who was about this high, so I'm just curious about that, but it's a great song.
Oh,
So we got a request for a song, which we haven't done in God knows how long.
Oh, have mercy.
And this could be a train wreck, but what the heck? Well, I'm going to give it a try anyway. It's called Dr. Robert.
Plow Forth Brothers.
Be my friend, I said, you call Dr. Robert. Day or night, he'll be there any time at all. Dr. Robert, Dr. Robert, he has you a better man. He has you to understand. He has everything he can. Dr. Robert, live at first for the National Hill. Dr. Robert, donate money just to see yourself with Dr. Robert. Dr. Robert,
request from this young lady right out here who wanted to hear Yellow Submarine.
Yeah.
It's kind of interesting because usually Yellow Submarine is a request we get from people who are our age. Strangely enough.
Strange.
But it's a great song. Everyone loves it. And you know, that's the great thing about the Beatles' music is that it appeals to all ages. They've really got a little bit of everything for everyone.
Live the man who set the sea.
things we said today. I just seen her face and things we said today. And help in a hard day's night.
Wow, she's got a lot of requests saved up. We got a request for yesterday.
Yesterday, all my troubles seem so far away. Now it looks as though they're here to stay. Oh, I believe in yesterday. Suddenly, I'm not half the man I used to be. There's a shadow hanging over me. Oh, yesterday.
Slapper, and clap your hands, slap your knees, rattle your jewelry, whatever you would like to do. But this is a great one.
Yeah.
Ben on guitars in that one.
What else we got, Denise? No, there was another one.
Any other requests? Oh, you just love Lucy. Lucy in the Sky. Any others?
Octopus Garden.
Octopus's Garden. Oh, If I Fell. Okay, If I Fell. For that one, Denise. I Will.
Let It Be.
Let It Be. Things We Said Today. In My Life. Okay. Imagine. Okay. You go with those, Denise? Okay.
What do we do? Things We Said Today. Okay. Oh, one. Oh, one. Oh, one, two, three, four. For Lucy in the Sky with Diamonds, which is off the Sgt. Pepper album, arguably the most pivotal album in the history of rock and roll. This is a song that John Lennon did. A lot of people kind of had some misconceptions about what Lucy in the Sky with Diamonds meant. It was really a picture that Julian Lennon had drawn about one of his classmates. That's John Lennon's story, and we're going with it.
Picture yourself in a boat on a river with tangerine trees and marmalade sky. Somebody called you, you answered quite slowly.
you so much. Thank you. We got a request for In My Life, which is probably, could be one of the Beatles' most pretty song, I would say. It was John Lennon's favorite song of the Beatles. Of course, he wrote it, but what would you expect from John? But we're going to feature Fran on this one, and we're going to send it out to all you wonderful folks.
And I'm going to give this little dedication to my good friend Steve and Kathy. Been friends with them for a long, long time. They come out to a lot of our concerts, and Steve and I just took a 1,000-mile road trip a couple of weeks ago. We had a good time, so this one's for you guys. Woo! Thanks for your support. Yeah. And by the way, Steve, Kevin, and I all graduated in the same class in Burlington High School, and Bob also went to Burlington High. And Phil, we made an honorary Burlington High alumni.
I drive there sometimes.
Oh, one, two, three, four. Thank you so much. We got a request for Octopus's Garden, which is another one of those kiddie songs that the Beatles did, which they let Ringo sing. And it's again, just another example, I think, of how the Beatles tried to appeal to such a wide range of listeners out there. And I don't know who requested this, but I'm guessing you're probably not a child.
Give your child at heart.
Yes.
Those where we've been, it was all for us to start it.
Thank you. Thank you so much. That's Fran on vocals. So we got a request for Imagine, which is technically, again, not a Beatles song. It's a post-Beatles John Lennon song, but people are so fond of it, we get so many requests for that song that we kind of cut a little slack there and we do it. If I Fell, which is it's a John Lennon ballad, and which is kind of interesting because it's really a pretty kind of mushy, syrupy ballad, which was typically what Paul McCartney wrote.
Very mushy.
But this one is a pretty tune, great harmonies.
If I fell in love with you, would you promise to be true and help me understand? 'Cause I've been in love before, and I found love was more than just holding hands. Love me for
you. Oh, thank you so much. We lost Denise, but yeah, why not while you have that on? So while Phil has got that 12 string around his neck, we're gonna do a song. Help. Oh, that's right, we did get a request for help, didn't we? Yeah, let's do that.
I got some requests coming.
So we got a request for help. And, a Hard Day's Night.
Well, you stop that. Two Hard Day's Night.
We got a lot of requests and not a lot of time to fit them in. We're going to do our best, though. I don't know whether everyone turns into a pumpkin at 7 o'clock tonight.
You will.
We will? We might.
You pumpkin, you.
We might. But we'll see if we can stretch it just a little bit.
It's been a hard
so much. Thank you. So we got a request for another song, which Paul McCartney does at every single concert because people just love it so much. It's Let It Be. And this is a song that some people mistake for having some religious connotations, especially the Mother Mary piece. Actually, Paul wrote this for his mom, whose name was Mary. She died when Paul was fairly young. And so this was somewhat of a dedication to her.
Let it be.
Thank you so much. We got a request for something. Oh, I get it. I get that joke. Can you play something? Yeah, something like what? No, it's, this is a George Harrison number, which, you know what, poor George Harrison, he never quite got the recognition he deserved with the Beatles. He's a great composer, he's a great singer, great player, and here's a good example of that song that really, I think, was probably his highlight with the Beatles.
See? Yeah. Good. So, do you guys want us to end, like, right at 7 or...
Keep playing.
Oh, yeah, sure. Right before our last film. Okay. Absolutely.
Oh, we got special absolution. Why don't we just put it to something? We're going to stretch it a little bit.
Something. A 1, 2, 3.
Baby, send your mind, you know what you tell me.
Thank you, thank you. So we're going to hear the results of the raffle. So all of you, get your tickets out, take a close look, put your glasses on, get your flashlights out if you need them.
Boy, does this bring back memories. 70s people, woo! All right, woo! Those were the good years. Oh, they're all good years. Okay, and the number. Who's gonna pick? Emily's gonna pick from the band.
Oh, absolutely.
Uh-oh, gonna pick.
Denise, what's your number?
The winning ticket for $132.50. Are you ready? 034-7137. 7137. Okay.
Woo! You're buying at the beer truck.
A surprise second prize from BioClean Green Carpet Cleaning Service, a free carpet cleaning service. And you'll see Richard in the bio tent. You ready? Go ahead. Emily's going to draw. Okay. And the lucky winner is 034-7100. 7100. Where are you? Whoop! Okay, over there. Come on up. We'll give him this. And if you go up to the BioClean tent, they'll give you all the details. Congratulations. Okay, one more. One more announcement. We have had the liveliest dancers here tonight. Paul and Arnett. Not both of them. 95 years old. Paul is a World War II veteran. All right, give him a clap. We'll see you next year. Thank you. Oh, they're going to stand up. All right. Woo! Standing, I'm going to ask everybody to please stand up and thank Jill Benis for what she did to bring this concert series back. She's a dynamo. Get up.
Good job.
You go, sister.
And then another round of applause. This was the committee, the volunteer committee, myself, Karen, Emily, and Joe. Give it up. Made it happen. You too can wear a vest like this next year. Sign up under the red tent. Thank you all. You guys are awesome, and you'll be back next year.
All right? Before we go, we're going to take you all out.
Okay. I'm going to take them up.
I'll take you out with a medley.
We thought you were a nice guy.
So don't leave. Don't leave. We got a little more to go.
Stay right where you are. Boy, these ladies make me feel really tall.
I see you,
yes.
Jimmy.
Oh, you're echoing.
Yes, we also want to send out a big thank you to the event staff for having us here tonight. We really appreciate it. You guys have been a terrific audience. You really have. And we really appreciate all of your responsiveness. So, as Bob said, we are going to send you off on your way with a little medley. We end all of our concerts with this medley because it's such a beautiful set of tunes, and also it's the very last songs the Beatles did on the very last album. We are sure that you've heard it and you probably know the words, so sing along with us, please.
Once there was a way to get back home.
Good night, everybody.